Good day to you from Chem Help ASAP. Let's see two dihalogenation reactions. Here are our reactions. In the top reaction, we have methyl cyclohexene reacting with Br2, bromine. The mechanism begins with the weakly nucleophilic alkene attacking the strongly electrophilic Br2. The mechanism involves three arrows. Let's assume that the Br2 approaches from the top face of the alkene. We get a bromonium ion as our intermediate. The three-membered ring is going to open up. It gets opened by the bromide counterion. The bromide attacks at the more substituted side of the bromonium ion from the bottom face of the structure. It attacks opposite from the first bromine. The resulting product is this dibromide . Note that the methyl group was down and it gets pushed up as the bromine comes in from the bottom face. Note that the two new bromines are trans with respect to the ring of the molecule. Dihalogenation is an antiaddition. At the bottom is another reaction. This time we have an acyclic alkene and we'll react it with chlorine, Cl2. I've shown the halogens on the alkene because we'll need them for reference. Let's also number the carbons in our chain. The mechanism is essentially the same. There we go. We'll assume that the Cl2 attacks from the top face. That gives us a chloronium ion. The hydrogens, I'm going to leave them the same as we draw this chloronium ion on the top face. And you may say that stereochemically that looks weird. You're right. We'll fix it in the next picture. When the chloride opens up the chloronium ion ring, it will attack from the back face, opposite of the first chlorine. I'll arbitrarily attack on carbon 4. When we draw the product, we'll keep the main chain the same. Carbon 3 will have the chlorine up, so the hydrogen must be down. Carbon 4 will have the chlorine back because it came in from the back face, and the hydrogen will have been pushed up. Seeing syn and anti with acyclic alkenes can be a challenge, but we've drawn this product to make the anti relationship, one up, one down, of the chlorine atoms as clear as possible.